All right, we have an industrial machine here. So this runs a major, some important machine in the factory. So apparently they did some testing and can confirm that, oh yeah, they put a replacement motherboard in here and the machine works with all the other components. So the problem, we're told, is with the motherboard and whether we can do anything about it. Holy crap. Wow, okay. What the hell is this? These are ISA cards. Jeez, that's the RAM. That is the motherboard. UMC. Wow. Reset in. Wow, this is not a system I want to mess with. There's even switches made in Taiwan. Wow. Switches to change the inputs or settings, parameters. SMC, that's looks like a network. No, they're all serial. Two serial. One serial. Oh, that's a VGA. It's a graphic card. VRAMs. Wow. What is this guy? That's another serial port. There are the EEPROMs. Wow. Artec. Look at these resistors. Gee, what did I accept? Made in UK. Oh, that's a hard drive. Hard drive made in UK? No way. Status, temperature, hard drive, floppy drive. Tension, voltage. So what do we got? Power, good. Furnish, reset in, reset out. So that's the ATX power, I mean, not really ATX. No, it's a proprietary connector. So, what happens when you plug in the power? Off. So it goes through here? Yes, it doesn't turn on. These fans are working. So why is the unit here? Thank you. So it's 1996. 47 gigabyte. 200 watt power. CH-5012. Wow, cool. Curious to see what it shows on the VGA. All right, let's get a VGA cable. Where do I get a VGA cable? VGA cable, do I have a box for it? I should have one. VGA, oh yeah, I got one. I'll plug this one in. Turns on by itself. This has only one input anyway, so original. But this looks like the main motherboard. Okay, let me get some more information. Wow. Alright, be right back. Alright, going back to the industrial PC. We always get status 00. So, I've disconnected the floppy. Floppy ribbon cable. LPT port cable, PCI ISA 1 card, ISA 3 card, couple of cables, try different slots for the RAM, remove a 5 pin wire, and mini ribbon cable, all the same. We don't get a post. So this is the motherboard. This is what actually runs the computer. It's actually a proper computer. There is a speaker here. It's got the IDE connections. IDE, floppy, something else. That was a PC, parallel port, I think. Doesn't have onboard VGA. So these are the keyboard mouse inputs. That could be the Super I/O maybe, I don't know. But there are more components on the inside. And this is the RAM. Alright, be right back. Okay, let's have a look at this, see if we can spot anything obvious. So, going back to the history, they took this motherboard out, put it into another working computer, it wouldn't work. And they took that motherboard, the other computer's motherboard, put it into this computer, and the computer worked. So that's how they reached the conclusion that the problem is with this board. We're looking for anomalies. Alien lifeline. Oh, that one is leaking. L, so that would be a coil. And what is that? Dirt. Okay. Dirt is not gonna help us, will it? No. Hey look, 486 BIOS. So this is a 486 computer. Wow. That's usually a network port. I mean, I always see that company network, but that's, you know, maybe not the case anymore, depending on what they were manufacturing at the time. If there was a problem with the power, it wouldn't turn on. So power is not the issue. Like, it shouldn't be like a short, rather something else. $256K. Maybe the CPU is not responding. So this is the other side. I'll bring the torch and have a look with the torch, just in case I miss something or I will miss something. So far, nothing. That is definitely a 486. How did they mount that in place? Just brackets. Oh, it'll be tricky, hey? Ah, I think there was a fan on this which is missing. I think this is cooked. So look, I remember, I'm not that old, but I remember the way they mounted the fans, the screw holes will just go into these gaps. And there was a fan here. The fan is missing. Could be a high chance that the CPU is cooked. So how is the CPU mounted here? Why is this not coming off? Does this just come off? Oh, let's light out. Okay. Yeah. Operation. Wow, what an ancient. At least it's not a 286 or some weird AMD chip. Okay, I'll be right back. Alright, so I don't know what the problem is. I can't test this CPU, neither can I buy one. Only from US or something. Now, will this have a little lock? Or something I can twist? I can free up the CPU? Thank you. made in Malaysia. There is some dirt there, but that's normal. Not a big deal. Be right back. Okay, so that loud noise is from the computer. I'll put the CPU back. Into the computer. No display, no post. I'm gonna move it a slot to the left. With one memory module. CPU doesn't even get hot. Error code is 00. There is a reset in and reset out. What does that mean? What's the cable in the power supply? No reaction at all, nothing. It should even make beeping sounds when there is no RAM. It doesn't make that either. So I'm going towards the issue with potentially an issue with the CPU. That is a good option to consider. Okay, I'll give them that option, see what they want to do, and we'll go based off that. It should make a beeping sound when there's no RAM either, or GPU. It does nothing. Alright, we'll be back.